them first. There is nine of them, which you can find in Galatians 5:22. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such, there is no law. Amen?
Amen.
So love. Not just an emotion or feeling. It's a decision to commit for the well-being of others, unconditionally. I also have the Greek definition, which is agape, love which seeks the highest of others. I may not give to all of them, so I'm just going to give you the definition. Joy, not based on circumstances obtained by doing the will of God, like sharing the gospel, fellowship with others. And the Greek definition, the word is chara, gladness, delight, a special presence of God. Peace, this is the state of assurance, lack of fear provided only by God. Also, it is the unity between believers. Freedom from worry and oppressive thoughts. The Greek definition, eirin, peace between individuals, harmony, and unity. Patience. Slowness in avenging wrongs. The quality which keeps the believer from responding to negative situations out of the hatred and anger, etc. The Greek definition, makarpia, long-suffering, bearing fruits without complaints. Kindness. The eagerness to put others at ease, a sweet and attractive temperance that shows friendly regards. The Greek word, then definition, kerotes, merciful, easy to bear, morally good and upright. Goodness, selfless desires to open yourself and generous to others, even when they don't deserve it. Mm-hmm. Greek definition, the word is agathon, useful, generous. Faithfulness, firm devotion to God. Loyalty to friends, discharging responsibilities properly. The belief that Jesus died for our sins. The Greek word is pistis, which is trust and conviction. Gentleness, humble, non-threatening demeanor that derives from a position of strength and authority and is useful in calming another's anger. This is not the being weak and passive. The Greek definition, paratus, humble and meek. And the last fruit is self-control. Restrain one's emotions, actions, and desires, and to be in harmony with the will of God. Self-control is God's will, not living for oneself. The Greek word is ekrate, and the definition is being in control of one's self. Amen?
Amen.
So, I wrote all nine down, and I put a little bit of my life in there. The nine fruits of the Spirit, and the first one is love. And that's 1 John 4:16. And as I said, we might not get to all of them. That's why I gave you the definitions to all of the nine fruits of the Spirit. 1 John 4:16 says, and we have known all and believed the love that God has to us. God is love. And he that dwelleth in love dwelleth in God, and God in him. Amen?
Amen.
I wrote, when the love of the Holy Spirit started to flow and enter into my personality, that is when I began to love God, myself, and others around me. I'm learning that through Jesus Christ, my greatest goal is to do all things in love. I read something very powerful here that says, you can be the greatest man or woman of God and have all the greatest gifts of God flowing through you, but if you're not walking with all of this in the spirit of love and humility,
yes,
it would have been for naught.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Joy. Nehemiah 8:10. Nehemiah 8:10.
Then he said, unto them, go your way, eat the fat and drink the sweet, and send portions unto them for whom nothing is prepared. For this day is holy unto our Lord. Neither be ye sorry, for the joy of the Lord is our strength. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
We need joy in the times we're living in. Yes. And the joy we get from God is real joy.
Yes.
When I wake up in the morning, that's when I have much joy. Yes. Knowing that I get another chance to show Christ to someone else.
Yes.
God's grace is the best joy that someone can experience.
Yes. Yes.
Peace. Peace starts when you know who you are.
Yes.
And that no weapon formed against you can prosper. Isaiah 54:17. I'm going to keep reading. That is real peace. Yes, attacks and distractions will come. The key about handling every situation is that God knows everything that is going on. We must remember that the battle is not ours and that the enemy has been defeated because of the act that happened on the cross. I am learning that the Holy Spirit has his peace, and he wants to give it to me in great abundance. Hallelujah. Long-suffering. Isaiah 58:8-9. Long-suffering is a major dilemma for Christians. Our God is a very patient and long-suffering God. His way are not our ways. This fruit is very important when dealing with family and loved ones. I did my own thing for a very long time, making everyone around me suffer. But thank God that he helped others be long-suffering and patient with me.
Amen. Amen.
Kindness. Kindness is a fruit that works hand in hand with love. When I show kindness to others, especially non-believers or people that haven't accepted Christ, you show the love of God through that fruit. I have asked the Holy Spirit to help me in that fruit towards my children and co-workers. 2 Corinthians 6:6. You can show kindness easily to the people you don't know, but it's the ones around you.
Yes.
Well,
amen.
Well, I could, but it's the ones around you to see that the fruit. Sorry, let me say that. Well, I could, but it's those around me that need to see the fruit manifested in me.
Amen.
We can easily be nice to people we don't know because they're gonna leave.
That's right. Yes.
Goodness. 2 Thessalonians 1:11, and also Ephesians 5:9. You can have the actual goodness of God shining through you to reach others. I remember when I first started working as a dental assistant, the endodontist would always start with me because she knew that I didn't know what I was doing, and she didn't want to train me. She was used to the other assistant. She would ask me to do things and know that I didn't know how to do them. She would embarrass me in front of the patients. She went even far as telling on me. She told the office manager I didn't know what I was doing, which they already knew because I started there as a school, right, as a student. After a couple of months of working with her and passing many tests and trials, she began to see the goodness that was in me.
Okay.
I remember one day she came to me and she said, I need a huge favor from you. She said, would you watch my children at my home?
Jesus, hallelujah.
I was honored and said, wow, amen. Jesus. Gentleness, 2 Corinthians 10:1. I know that I need to be gentle with people. This fruit is very important,
yes,
as the others. People have been beaten up and hurt in their, yes, dealings with others in and out of the church. One gentle word or touch from another Christian can really open the door. It can open the door to Jesus and his healing, saving, deliverance power into their lives. Amen?
Amen.
Faith. Hebrews 11:6. Faith is the fruit that applies to our everyday life. Faith is one quality that God, the Father, is really watching all of us on. He is watching who is going to stay true and loyal and also faithful to him. Also to the demands in our lives. God, the Father, really holds this particular fruit in high esteem. And this is one quality that he will really expect us to